Hello everyone, welcome to Study EETech. In this video, we are going to discuss single phase half wave controlled rectifier with resistive load. Half wave controlled rectifier is the most fundamental AC to DC conversion technique. And if we understand this half wave controlled rectifier clearly, that will help us to understand other circuits, full controlled rectifier, half controlled rectifier, three phase, and all these things. Let's start. Well, the step-by-step understanding procedure in this lecture will be, first we will discuss the circuit diagram, then we will come to the equivalent circuit based on the switching of in the circuit diagram, then we will take waveforms to analyze, we will analyze the circuit and draw the waveforms. Next, at last, we will come to the mathematical expression of the circuits. Start with the circuit diagram. As we can see here, single phase supply has been given in the input side, and there is a transformer, and this transformer output voltage is Em sin omega t, a pure sinusoid we are considering here. In the series path, there is a thyristor whose voltage across it we are considering Vt1, thyristor name is T1, and after that the resistive load is connected R, and the voltage across the load is Edc, and the circuit is complete here. So this is the simplest circuit. So what is the function of this thyristor here? Thyristor can simply either be switched on or it can be switched off, nothing else. And remember, at this point, all the power electronic devices use a semiconductor device in the switching mode. Okay. So the equivalent circuit can be either if considering the switch is on and considering the switch is off. If the switch is on, this path will be closed and this is the circuit, and if the switch is off, the path is open here. So open and close, what does it mean? If the switch is on, the ID will be present. If the switch is off, ID will be zero. That is the only difference. And the voltage appearing across the load, EDC, will be zero here and EDC will be the input voltage here. Next, this is the waveform. So to understand the waveform, we have taken the circuits, the equivalent circuits. This is the main circuit. In the supply voltage, we are considering this point voltage Em sin omega t. So the Em sin omega t is here. This is the input voltage, right? This is the input voltage. And the firing pulses that are given to the thyristor T1 is given at the point alpha. Alpha is between 0 to pi, right? So it is right before the 90 degree, as we can see in the waveform. So a short pulse is given to the thyristor to trigger it. Remember, at this point, the short pulse is required for triggering the thyristors, IG. And if we take out the pulse after giving us for a short duration, the thyristor will remain in on state until the current goes below something called the holding current. We have discussed this holding current, latching current in one of our previous video that is available in this channel. You can browse it and you can watch that. It will be clear. Okay. So there are three modes. One is 0 to alpha, alpha to pi, pi to 2 pi. Right. So 0 to alpha, we can see the circuit will be this one. Let me take pen. Well, so from 0 to alpha, the circuit is 1. The circuit is 1. From alpha to pi, the circuit is 2, the mode 2. So the circuit is of the 2. Okay. So if from this 0 to this alpha, we see the output voltage is 0. Why? Because it refers to the circuit 1. So look here, the circuit is 1. So for this circuitry, 0 to alpha, the switch is open here. So if the switch is open, the output voltage is 0 because current is not flowing through it. So we get the output voltage 0. And from alpha to pi, okay, from alpha to pi, we see the output voltage will be same as the input voltage. Why? Because we are considering the second circuit. Not we are considering, it is appearing that the mode of the circuitry will be this one. Okay, the switch is closed. And we are also considering that the voltage drop across the switch is zero. So the entire input voltage Em sin omega t will appear here. So we will get this voltage, which is nothing but this voltage, which is copied and pasted here. So up to pi. Now, what about the current? Well, we are coming to the current later on. From pi to 2 pi, right? From pi to 2 pi, the switch will be off. Okay. If the switch is off, we will get the equivalent circuit mode is 1. And if the equivalent circuit mode is 1, we will get the output voltage is 0, right? So if the output voltage is 0, we will get the 0 voltage here. Okay. Well, what about the current? Because we are using here the resistive load only, right? So because of the resistive load, the current will be in phase with the input voltage. So this is the input voltage divided by the R. So the where the voltage maximum occurs, there the current max will occur. Where the voltage zero occurs, there the current zero will occur. Okay. So at this point, we can say at the point pi, the current is zero, and that will below the holding current of the thyristor, and that will make the thyristor off. Okay. So if the thyristor is off, the switching mode will be the equivalent circuit mode 1 will appear here. So you will get 0 voltage. And from 2 pi to alpha, same thing will happen whatever happened in the previous cycle. So here. So at this point, alpha to pi, the current will be 0 because simply the current will not flow through this path. Okay. So what is the voltage across the thyristor? Look, voltage across the thyristor will only appear whenever the thyristor is off. So thyristor remains off from this point to this point, right? From this point to this point, this is off. Okay, so we will get this voltage. Okay, so we will get the input voltage, right? And from alpha to pi, the equivalent circuit is the equivalent circuit is 2. So we are getting the 0 output voltage. And from pi to 2 pi, look, we are measuring this point voltage A with respect to B, VAB. Okay. So we are taking this one positive, and here we have to take the negative because the polarity has been changed to negative, positive in the negative half cycle. And again, this will be copied and pasted for the previous cycle. So this will be the waveform, various waveform for single phase half wave controlled rectifier. Now look, the mathematical expression for this circuitry will be the average voltage. Okay, so let me take the laser pointer again. Now look, the output voltage EDC, it is the cycle is from 0 to 2 pi. So 1 by 2 pi, so 0 to 2 pi, but out of 0 to 2 pi, alpha to pi is present. So the lower limit will be alpha, the upper limit is pi, Em sin omega t. So if we derive it, we will come to this simple form. Okay, so this is clear to you. Next, we are going to find out the average load current. Simply, it will be divided by R. Average load voltage by R will be the average load current. And the RMS voltage, right? The RMS voltage will be ERMS equal to, everything will remain same, only the input voltage square, we will take the mean like the average, then we will take the root of it. And after this rigorous integration, we will come to this simple form. Okay, so this is this way we can find out the, or we can understand the single phase half wave controlled rectifier. And look here, the average voltage equation that is coming to 1 plus cos alpha. Okay, so the current cannot be, the voltage cannot be negative. And one more thing at this point, that is the single phase half wave control rectifier, because you can control the half of the full cycle and you are getting zero voltage here. That's why the name evolved, so half wave control rectifier. Okay, hope you understood it well. Hope you have enjoyed the video. Study EETech is happy to serve you. If you have any queries or doubts, please put it in the comment box. Your suggestions will help us to make better content and grow high. Press the like button, subscribe to our channel, and share it among your friends. Press the bell icon to get further notification of newly uploaded video in this channel. Follow our blog site, follow our Facebook page, download our Android app. Links are given in the video description. Thanks for watching.